This week on NFL.com, Shannon Sharp talks about the tight races in all the divisions and how no team is running away with it this year. Read more about it on NFL.com. Texas take over first and 10 at the 30. Offense needs to get something going now. They've struggled with their rhythm. Here's Carr. Looking backside, he's got an open man. Didn't get to him soon enough. And Jason Taylor hauls him down once again. Fourth sack of the day, second for Taylor.
Yeah, this is a coverage sack, Gus. As Carr comes out, he just tries to go through his progression, has to step up in the pocket. Jason Taylor, when he gets loose, he's gonna run you down faster than you can get rid of it. You see there as he spins out of Ephraim Salam, who's back in the ball game after being out for a few plays. Get their regular left tackle back in there, but it still leads to a sack by Jason Taylor.
Texans have struggled in the third quarter as they hand it off to Dane. And Ron Dane powers his way to the 34-yard line.
One of the things we haven't spoken about, Gus, is that Dom Capers, the former head coach of the Houston Texans, is the defensive signal caller for the Miami Dolphins. And one of the things he's brought to the team is their ability to move that guy there around. Jason Taylor can stand up and play with his hand off the ground. He can also move up onto the line of scrimmage, and there's Dom Capers. He uses that 3-4 defense to help hide Jason Taylor and give him different opportunities to rush the passer.
Third down 8 at the 32. Carr throwing to the sideline, caught. Moles! Moles breaks it back inside, and Moles goes down at the 44. Great throw, beautiful catch. Tillman with the tackle, a gain of 28.
And I'll tell you, Gus, if they're not gonna pressure David Carr, he's gonna pick him apart. He's got a nice rifle arm. You see there the nice out route by Moles. The ball's in the air before his head comes around. It's a great anticipation throw by Carr, right on the money.
First down and 10 at the Miami 40. Cook, Dane in the backfield. Here's Ron Dane. And Ron Dane gets to the 35. Scanina with the tackle. Vikings at Buffalo today. Here's JB.
Hey, Gus, talk about back to the future. Peerless Price, former Buffalo Bill, back with Buffalo. Take a look at this toss here. Has to gather J.P. Lossman's low throw. Poor tackling, great highlight. All of that was just 8 yards. His first touchdown of the season. Buffalo on top, 14-6. Back to Gus and Steve.
All right, JB, Peerless Price, you can always go home. Play action, this one dumped off. Ron Dane tripped up by Zach Thomas. Actually, Zach Thomas with a leg whip on Ron Dane.
Number 54 of the defense. 10-yard penalty, first down.
And I'll tell you what, I don't know if that was the right play by Zach Thomas, but he didn't know if he was going to gain 10 yards, but he did trip him, no question. Ron Dane was going to get out of this tackling. Watch right there, just hooks him. You can't do that. And I'll tell you what, Gus, it's just reflex. I mean, you're trying to tackle a guy, Zach Thomas. He doesn't miss very many tackles, and he won't go down without a fight. He's going to get a piece of you.
First and 10 at the 19. Dane, the deep man, play fake. Carr throws on the run. Ball is shot, Andre Johnson, and he's not out of bounds. Ronnie Holiday knocking him out of bounds.
Well, I'll tell you what, Gus, this is a big drive for the Texans. Deep into the third quarter. This is the first time they've been there this half. They've got a nice drive going here, but they're doing it mostly through the air with a little bit of compliment for the run game. It's important now, Gus, that they go for the touchdown, but don't make the huge mistake. Stay smart, just like they've been able to do.
Second and 8 at the 17. Underneath, that ball is caught. It's like Walter. Tillman wraps him up.
That's Kevin Walter right there. He's the free agent that came over from Cincinnati. He's a big inside receiver. This is exactly what he's good at. Give him a tough, tight, fast throw inside. He'll catch it with his body and get the first down. And that was a rifle by David Carr. And that is a great, great play for the first down, down close.
First down and goal at the 8. Ron Dane. And Rondane gets to the five. Zach Thomas again, along with Kevin Carter, 3-yard gain.
You know, it's interesting, they have one wide receiver on the field, and it's Eric Molds. And I think one reason is because Eric Molds is an extremely good blocker. Now they'll send Andre Johnson back onto the field, along with Kevin Walter, and they pull out Jameel Cook and Daniel Owens, or Owen Daniels, because they want to, this looks like a passing formation. They're going to put, spread the defense out and make them cover their entire width of the field, Gus.
Rondane in the backfield. Here's the big fella. Dane leading forward. And he's down at around the goal line. And that's the end of the third quarter. 6-3 Miami. Houston knocking on the door. We'll return after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS, Arkansas, Auburn, then LSU, Florida. College football at its best next Saturday on CBS.
CSI, CBS Thursdays.
The art of the photograph reaches inside the eyes and the minds of the most creative of all of today's photographers. Discover all the secrets of those who specialized in photographing the stars. Art of the Photograph, only on Hollywood Star.
Good news. You don't need to live in the U.S. to enjoy American football. Touchdown with the NFL Sunday to Tuesday on Orbit ESPN. Athletic. Fast. Competitive, classy. Welcome to the land of total football. The Dutch League every week on Orbit. America Plus packs a punch. High drama, high jinx, hell's a poppin'. Grab you by the throat action.
Biggest set of downs of the Texans season thus far.
Third down goal at the one, out of the eye. Rondane.
Sensational play fake by David Carr. What great poise when he turned the corner. They did not know where the football was. He hides it on his stomach, takes one nice walk stick right there, styling it in. And watch, he throws it right into the stands.
And the extra point is up and good. The Houston Texans have turned it over twice, but they've taken the lead. 10-play drive, 70 yards, held it for 5-0-1. We've got a ball game in the Long Star State.
Our target is an ugly, smelly, dirty little scab of rock called Iwo Jima.
12,000 Japanese defenders in 8 square miles. They will not leave politely, gentlemen.
There she goes.
People on the street corners, they looked at this picture and they took hope. They said, we are winning this war.
Flags of Our Fathers, rated R, starts Friday, October 20th.
When it comes to being a better football fan, nothing beats Sprint NFL Mobile. You can watch exclusive game highlights of all your favorite players, like Peyton Manning. That guy's pretty good, if you like 6'5", 230-pound quarterbacks, laser, rocket arm. With NFL Mobile only from Sprint, you get customizable alerts and real-time stats on your favorite team. Maybe like Peyton Manning's team, maybe.
Get the power of the NFL in your hand, only with Sprint.
Oh, hoodie, monument to the durable. Fast friend, uncomplaining sucker of sweat. In our most trying times, you still tried. When other garments stopped at the neck, you said, oh no, the head needs a garage. Our arms would pull off well before yours, yet this is how we treat you.
A near-death experience.
Did your entire sordid, degenerate life flash before your eyes?
I wish.
Forces Charlie to do the unthinkable. Spend time with his mom.
When was the last time you had a prostate exam?
It's time to change my butt dressing.
You don't have to get snippet.
I am this close to sticking my tongue in a light socket.
A new 2.5 Men, CBS Tomorrow.
Welcome back. Texans have taken a 10-6 lead. David Carr with the bootleg. And he gets in the end zone on a great play-action fake. Wes Welker ready to return it. And Welker will take a knee. Chris Brown nailing it. Let's take another look at the David Carr touchdown.
We're going to see the play fake. Watch the running back come in, and it looks like he's got the football, and David Carr really sells the fake as well. Watch the running back fold his arms and run hard to the line of scrimmage. Try and get in the end zone, and look at the corner down here. He is completely out of it. That's Will Allen, who just got caught peeking inside.
So now Dante Culpepper and the Miami Dolphins offense has to respond. Culpepper out of the shotgun. In trouble. Breaks a tackle and is sacked. Is that Williams? Mario Williams! His first sack as a member of the Houston Texans.
He's excited.
And there is a gorilla. Did you see that gorilla that just jumped off his back?
He is excited, man, and so are the crowd. The crowd's going crazy as well. I'll tell you what, guys. Watch him as he comes up. Culpepper spins out of the sack by the secondary, and Williams is right there to engulf him. Right there.
And Williams needs to give a nice steak dinner to D'Amico Ryans, because he's the man that provided the pressure. Culpepper ball again, sacked again. Is that Williams again? Williams and Ryans.
They come in bunches, Gus. Watch as he comes off. He's working there against Alabi, gets underneath, and falls right there. And you're right, Gus, that's at least a half a sack between him and Ryan. And I'll tell you what, when things turn, Gus, all of a sudden, a team that's 0-3 has a huge home field advantage here with the lead in the fourth quarter.
6 sacks on the afternoon for the Houston Texans. 3rd and 20. Culpepper fires down the field. Incomplete. Sanders, great coverage. Marty Booker, the intended receiver. And the Dolphins will have to punt it away. But how about Mario Williams? He's got a pep in his step now.
Oh, man, we talked to him yesterday. And you're right, guys. He just needed the one thing to get over the hump, to make him feel like he was contributing and was getting something done. And he did it that series. He really did. It was a good sack on the first play, and then the second when he got in and finished off the sack.
Dolphins have to punt. Donnie Jones in the end zone. Little Buchanan back deep. And Buchanan from midfield. Buchanan bounces outside. Buchanan trying to turn the corner, can't, and it's dropped at the 42-yard line. Stopped by Ronaldo Hill. But the key play on the drive, Mario Williams with the first sack of his career.
Listen up, V-Dub in the house. Jason, this is your 98, whatchamacallit.
You got an F.
You know what we're gonna do now?
No.
Unpimp your auto. We just dropped it like it's hot. V-Dub, representing Deutschland.
The Volkswagen GTI, pre-tuned by German engineers.
Hey, over here.
Why don't you switch to our network? We're just like them.
Are you reliable?
Excellent question.
How about for email or downloading music?
Why not?
Only one wireless network is America's most reliable for calls, downloads, and emails.
That is a problem, and we are working on it.
Verizon Wireless, it's the network.
Coach, when it's this hot, can any beer be more refreshing than Coors Light?
No, I don't believe that. That's not possible.
We'll save a cold one for you, Coach.
Yeah.
I'm excited. I'm looking forward to it. I really am.
How do you choose between Coors Light and cold refreshment?
Well, I don't believe I can segregate the two.
It was a trick question.
Taste the cold of Coors Light, the official beer sponsor of the NFL.
Hey, Coach, we still got a 12-pack and four ice-cold cans.
Well, 12 and four is pretty good.
More than electricity or food, this town needs information. We could organize a group of people, send them out in every direction, north, south, east, and west. We can't just sit here in the dark.
I don't think anyone should be leaving Jericho.
If this country is at war, we need to know it.
Mario Williams, first three games, no sacks. Last drive, a sack and a half. So how about that? And Mario, very happy man.
Yeah, it's nice to see. You knew he'd be happy, but his teammates are all over him too. They know how big a moment that was for him. And we spoke to Ron Dayne, and the one thing he noticed, he's been here less than a month, this is a team that's together. They like each other and they're getting better. They like the atmosphere. It's a good place to play. And that, I think that was further proof of it. Those guys were happy for Mario.
Texas with their best starting field position. Carr drops it off to Dayne out of the backfield. And Ron Dayne goes down at the 37. Arizona and Atlanta facing each other today. Here's JB.
Defense doing the job here, Gus. Take a look at Kurt Warner's pass being tipped by linebacker Michael Boley. D'Angelo Hall there with the pop-up. He takes it 36 yards to pay dirt. Only two touchdowns in this game are by interception returns for scores. 22-10, Falcons in the fourth. Back to Gus and Steve.
Little Deion Sanders primetime dancing in the end zone. Falcons trying to bounce back after that big loss on Monday in New Orleans. Third and six. Carr down the field for Johnson. Oh, he stops and somehow makes the catch between two Miami defenders. That ball thrown short. A gain of 30. Travis Daniels and Tavarius Tillman. Well, couldn't bat it down.
David Carr takes a shot when he throws this. It comes out wobbling. This is the reason it's short. And you know what? Nick Saban said his big play guys had to make big plays. All of a sudden, the other side of the field, the big play guy for the Texans, Andre Johnson, comes up with an enormous catch down close. And all of a sudden, the Texans don't look like an 0-3 club.
Eight catches, 98 yards for Johnson. Ron Dayne. And Dayne goes down at the 4-yard line. Ron Dayne has been criticized an awful lot during his career with the Giants, with Denver, but he looks like he's finally starting to turn the corner after 7 years with Coach Kubiak.
And I think a lot of the time in New York, he was asked to do things in an offense that didn't play to his strengths. He's a runner a lot like Jerome Bettis, like a big guy like Jamal Lewis. Get him inside the tackles, let him bounce around and keep his feet a little bit, push the pile a little bit, and then later on he'll break a big one.
Second and goal at the 4. Dayne again leans forward and gets to the 3.5. Carter, Zach Thomas in there. There's Gary Kubiak. Started his NFL coaching career with the San Francisco 49ers in 94. He spent the last 11 seasons as the offensive coordinator of the Denver Broncos, winning two Super Bowls. He's from Houston, Texas. Played collegiately at Texas A&M, came out in 83, and he was drafted by the Broncos in the 8th round.
Yeah, he told his team and David Carr, if you do the work, this offense is gonna work. Just do the work and trust me.
Third and goal at the 3. Moles, the motion man. Carr throws it in the air for Johnson. Touchdown. How simple can it get?
You said it, Gus. That looked all too easy. And on a day when Will Allen has really played very well, he's going to remember this day for the two plays he missed. The bootleg when he got sucked in on the play fake. And on that play right there to the corner of the end zone when he got beat by Andre Johnson. You see here, the pass is in the air, and that just looks too easy.
So David Carr finds his favorite target, and the Texans take a 16-6 lead. Andre Johnson, 9 catches, a buck 01, 1 touchdown, and they are rocking and rolling in Houston.
Subway Daytime Drama presents Reggie Bush in The Rookie.
I'll never play.
Sure you will, kiddo. Just gotta stay hungry.
But if I eat this, I won't be hungry anymore.
Eat the sandwich! Subway restaurants. Tasty new premium steak sandwiches like the blackened Cajun steak, hot and fresh from the oven, and the new steak and cheese. Subway, eat steak!
Weekend dress golf. One big life. Four ways to dress it.
Go, boy, go!
Wednesday.
What's the psychology behind this DVD?
It's a souvenir.
Put the weapon down!
New criminal minds. Then, a new CSI New York starts off chilly.
Call an ambulance! Call 911!
Stabbed with an icicle?
Our evidence is about to turn into a big pool of water.
And ends up downright cold.
You and I were into each other, but every time we're in the same room together...
I didn't mean for this to happen.
A new CSI New York after Criminal Minds, Wednesday.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by GEICO, where 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Vonage. And... by Dockers San Francisco.
Welcome back. Texans take a 17-6 lead. Andre Johnson with the catch. 100-plus receiving yards in 5 of the last 6 games. Home games, rather.
That tells you, Gus, there's no cooking like home cooking.
Houston trailed 6-3 going into the fourth quarter. The Texans with the lead now as Welker takes a knee. But how about this graphic? The Texans trail after 3 quarters. They are 3-36. Leading right now, 17-6.
V-Dub here in full effect with Trey and his ride.
It looks like it could fly.
What time is it?
I don't know.
Time to unpimp the auto. Oh, snap! German engineering in the house, yeah.
The Volkswagen GTI, pre-tuned by German engineers.
Por el fútbol americano comienza con los niños. El programa NFL Youth les brinda la oportunidad de aprender jugando. Un deporte al alcance de todos.
La pasión comienza contigo.
This team of criminals are planning their next big score. Step one, get the tools they need for the job.
I want a 50 caliber machine gun.
Mike, it's a robbery!
Step two, make sure the people they love are kept in the dark.
Thought I saw you today.
Really?
Same kind of minivan, same color?
No.
New Smith, CBS Tuesday.
How about this graphic, folks? Last season, or this season, 483 yards, only 133 today. Ronnie Brown taken down quickly. That's Ryan, the middle linebacker. A loss of one.
I'll tell you what, they love D'Amico Ryans. They think he is going to be one of the best middle linebackers in the league. He's came out, he's a rookie, earned the starting job in a 3-4 defense. That's really difficult to do.
Culpepper over the middle. Randy McMichael with the catch. He picks up the first down. As he gets to the 33, Dante Robinson tackles him, but it's a gain of 14.
You know, Gus, the first thing you think about when you see Miami complete a pass like that here as they go no huddle is the Texans can't turn it down. They've got to keep the volume turned all the way up defensively and stay aggressive.
First and 10 at the 33. Here's the screen. Caught. Ronnie Brown gets down the sideline, tiptoes out of bounds at the 41-yard line in front of Dante Robinson, a gain of 8.
It's a smart play call right there. You know the defense of the Texans is kind of hyped up. Use their speed. Let them come in on the quarterback. Get some penetration. That way they'll be a little more hesitant next time thinking about that screen pass you just got them for. But the defense has still got to be strong and aggressive, Gus. They can't turn it down now. The Dolphins are still in this game.
Second and 2 at the 41. Here comes a blitz. Culpepper over the middle. Marty Booker catches it on the run. Gets out of bounds at the 45. Dante Robinson hanging all over him, but Marty Booker picks up 14.
And this is where I think, Gus, Dante Culpepper is going to kind of help the Dolphins. You can do this when you've got a guy who's been in the league a while. Nothing's going to fluster Culpepper. He's been there before and knows how to act in these kind of situations. This is not a young quarterback out there, even though he's not very long in this offense.
Welker makes the first man miss. And Wes Welker, nice run after the catch, gets to the 37. Dexter McCleon, Glenn Earl combining on the tackle. It's a gain of 8.
I'll tell you what, Welker, you put him out in space and get the ball in his hands, and Nick Saban knows the guy's a great return man. Put him in a little space, give him a slot, and put the ball in his hands and see what he can do. You may get a big play, and that was a really good first down play.
Now Culpepper underneath to his tailback. Ronnie Brown slides, gets up, and goes down inside the 30. Ryans brings him down, but it's a 10-yard gain. And just like that, Miami has marched the ball right up the field.
It didn't look, he did go down, no question, but he has to be touched once he's down. There's a question as to whether he was, as you see there. Lewis Sanders is down on the field after that play finished up.
Take a timeout, 7:25 to play in the fourth. Texans up 17-6.
Baby, you can't leave me. I didn't know you didn't like that.
Look, Melissa, you know I like you, but I just don't see where this relationship is heading. Okay, I'm sorry.
Talk all you want, just $24.99 a month.
Sweet. Vonage!
Are you okay?
Mom, we got Vonage!
Wait, I'll do anything you want.
Vonage, one smart decision among many, many stupid ones. Click or call today.
Listen up, V-Dub in the house. Jason, this is your 98, whatchamacallit.
You got an F.
You know what we're gonna do now?
No.
Unpimp your auto. We just dropped it like it's hot. V-Dub, representing Deutschland.
The Volkswagen GTI, pre-tuned by German engineers.
Is rising, and just wait until Miami hits 100 murders, 100
100 killers, 100 episodes. Miami's never been more dangerous, and you won't believe what happens next.
He is gambling on human lives.
CSI Miami's 100th episode, all new CBS Tomorrow.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Diet Pepsi. Live NFL, drink Diet Pepsi. And by the 200 horsepower Volkswagen GTI. Make friends with your fast.
And welcome back. Lewis Sanders shaken up on the last play, but he walks off the field on his own. May have injured his lower back. He's trying to stretch it out right now. What is that, Steve, called? Is that the Lombard?
I think it's the low back.
Sure. I like that.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say it's the low back.
So here comes Dante Culpepper. First and 10 at the Texans 28. Culpepper hands it off. Ronnie Brown with running room. Brown tackled inside the 10. Great call. Derek Johnson gets him, but it's a 19-yard gain.
Tough to make a running play work when you've got a corner blitz on, and the corner just couldn't get there in time, and that's Ronnie Brown's speed that just pays off for the Dolphins. What a great run.
11 carries, 44 yards for Brown. First down and goal at the 9-yard line for the Miami Dolphins. Marty Booker, the receiver at the top of your screen. Welker in the slot. Here's Chambers, near side, drops it.
I'll tell you, Gus, all of a sudden, it's gotten awfully loud down in that end of the field. I mean, this is a crowd that has really come alive now, and Dante Culpepper in this no huddle is really having trouble communicating with the guys outside. And it's more of a thing that gets you keyed up as a player because it puts you in a little bit of desperation. You're not really sure exactly what the play is unless you hear it from Dante's lips, and they can't hear a thing.
Here's Culpepper. Underneath, Ronnie Brown. Brown dives forward, out of bounds inside the 5. Glenn Earl is there. So that will bring up third down and goal at about the 4-yard line.
So I guess this is almost 4-down territory. Even though we're still got a lot of time left in the fourth quarter, you're still 2 scores down. You see Ronnie Brown trying to reach it in, but we've got some good play calling down here. They've got to be able to run the football down close, but I think if you're going to go for it, you can run the football on this play. If you're not, throw it.
Ronnie Brown, a single setback. McMichael in motion. Here's Culpepper looking. Culpepper throws, incomplete. Intended for Chambers.
Great defensive play, good pressure. You're right. I called it, Gus. They threw the football because they're not going to go for it on fourth down as Mare comes in to kick the field goal. And I'll tell you what, that's just the strength of Dante Culpepper right there. And he almost got caught throwing the pick, trying to avoid the sack. And that would have been the end of it.
So Mare nails the field goal, a 22-yarder. He's 3 for 3. 52, 29, and 22-yard field goal. 17-9. 5:41 to play in the fourth. Culpepper sacked 5 times, hurried 11 times, knocked down 13 times.
And they also looked pretty good in that no huddle. They looked very good, knocking off big chunks of yards, getting it to their playmakers. Ronnie Brown was a huge factor in that drive as well. And now it comes down to the Miami defense. And we saw at the end of the first half, Gus, how the Texans went very conservative inside of 2 minutes and didn't do anything crazy. I think you're going to see a lot of that in this drive as well for the Texans. Don't look for them to be throwing this football all over the yard. As you see Jason Taylor, that smelling salts he's got there, that little ammonia capsule, making sure his head's right in the right place.